Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to print the prime numbers between 1 and 100 in Java. So let's get started. So for this purpose we will be having two for loops. Okay, so first let me give you the pseudo code of what we are going to do. So first we are going to have one for loop, and this for loop basically is going to iterate from the numbers 1 till 100. Okay, so this is the first for loop, and inside this for loop we will be having another for loop. Okay, and this for loop will basically check if these numbers from 1 to 100 is a prime number or not, and for that we will be also having a if condition inside this for loop. And with the help of this if condition we will be able to find if this number, any number between 1 and 100, is a prime number or not. And if that number is a prime number, here we will be just having a print statement and we will just print it. So this is the basic workflow. We will be having a for loop inside another for loop and a if condition inside the inner for loop. I hope this made sense. So let me just now go and write the main code. So as I told you, we will be having an outer for loop which basically iterates from the numbers 1 till 100. And another thing is that the first prime number is 2. 1 is not a prime number, okay? You can Google this. 1 is not a prime number. Prime number starts from 2. So you can just begin the for loop from 2 rather than 1, since 1 is not a prime number. So I'll just have int I equal to 2, I less than or equal to 100. Okay, you can just have less than 100 because 100 is not a prime number, but it's fine. And it's going to be I plus plus. So now we are done with the outer for loop. And as I told you, inside that we will be having another for loop which helps us to identify if this I, which are the numbers from 2 to 100, is a prime number or not. So I'll just go here and have for, and let me just have the variable name as j for that, int j equal to, this will start from 2, okay? Don't put 1 over there. You need to start from 2. If you put 1, every number will be divisible by 1 and you won't be getting anything in the output. So important thing, start from 2. It's going to be j less than I. Okay, you need to have j less than I, not less than or equal to I. Another important thing, because every number will be divisible by that number itself. So imagine I value is 5 and j value will also become 5. So 5 modulus of 5 will become like it won't be a prime number. So have it as j less than I, and it's going to be j plus plus. This is good. Now we are done, and inside this we will be having the condition. Okay, if condition. So if our number I, so these are the numbers from 2 to 100, right? If our number I modulus of j, so j value is obviously between 2 till this number. So imagine our I value is 5. We will do this condition, or we will test this for loop for numbers from 2 till 4, because j value is less than I is 5. So 2 till 4. So we will be basically dividing all the numbers below our I with I. So that's the condition over here. And if this is equal to 0, this is not a prime number, right? This is not a prime number. All right, I hope that made sense. If any of these numbers below I, so for example 2, 3, 4 is divisible by this number, we'll be getting the remainder as 0, which means that this is not a prime number. So for that case we need to have a flag over there. So for that flag, let me just come here inside the outer for loop. Okay, inside the first for loop, don't put it outside, it should be inside the outer for loop. Let me just have int flag equal to 0. So this is just a basic variable, and don't worry if you can't understand now, I will just explain it with a demo later. Okay, and what we can do here is that we can just have flag equal to 1, that's it. Okay, so this flag basically tells us if that number is divisible by any number between 2 till that number minus 1. Okay, so in case of our I value as 5, if this flag becomes true, which means that this number is not a prime number. But in case of 5, this flag will never become true because 5 is a prime number. Okay, this condition will never get satisfied. So we are having a flag, and we are done with the for loop also. And outside the inner for loop we just have a if condition. If our flag is still equal to 0, we will just print system dot out dot print, and we can just have here okay, and make sure that this if, okay, this if condition should come inside the first for loop, okay. So it's like this, it should come inside the first for loop. Alright, so this is the code, this is the code basically, and later I will show you two ways how you can optimize this code, okay. So first thing, let me just explain you what is happening here. So let me just go with a number, okay, because we are having so many values of I. Let me go with I value as 9, okay. Let me just consider I value as 9, okay. Just imagine 2 is over 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and over. Just imagine when the iteration comes to the value I equal to 9. It goes here, flag is currently 0. It goes inside this and we are having J value and this is the condition, okay. I is 9, okay, 9 modulus of J. J value is 2, J is 2. This condition becomes false, okay. This condition is false because J 9 is not perfectly divisible by 2 and we don't get the remainder as 0. Modulus operator just gives us the remainder, okay. So if this is 8, the remainder is going to be 0 because 8 is absolutely divisible by 2, but this is 9, which gives the remainder as 1 and this condition fails. Then J plus plus, now J value becomes 3 and this 9 is absolutely divisible by 3. So this condition becomes true and the flag finally becomes here 1, okay. So now the flag value becomes 1, it's not 0, okay. The value has changed. So after this, J value becomes 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It goes till 8. After this, the condition fails. It goes here. So it checks if the flag value is 0. But the number was divisible by 3, right? 9 was divisible by 3, which means that 9 is not a prime number. So only those numbers with a flag 0 are treated as a prime number. Because if a number is divisible by any number, it's not a prime number, right? So our flag becomes 1. So it comes here, flag is 0, checks the condition, our flag is 1, 9 doesn't get printed. So for example, imagine the number to be 11, okay? It comes here, imagine 11. So it comes here, 2, our flag is still 0, okay? It comes here, J initial value is 2, not divisible, not satisfied. 3 not satisfied, 4, 5, not at all satisfied. This value till goes till J10, okay? So none of the numbers divide 11 without any remainders, okay? So 11 is not divisible by any numbers below that. So this if condition will never get satisfied and most importantly, the flag will never become 1. It will remain 0, which is the initialized value to that. And after this for loop gets terminated, after the J value reaches 11 or something, it comes here, flag equality 0 and our flag is still 0 because this if condition was never satisfied and this condition becomes true and 11 gets printed because 11 is a prime number. So for all the prime numbers, the flag will be 0 and for all the non-prime zero numbers, the flag will be 1. Okay, I hope this makes sense. So let me just now run and check this if it works and after that I will show you some ways to optimize this code. Okay. Saving it and if I run it now, so here you can see I think we are getting all the prime numbers from 1 till 100, 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, yeah. So these are the prime numbers, I guess. If you want you can just check them out. Okay, the two optimization ways that I want to tell you here is that we can have a break. Okay, we can basically break this particular for loop. Okay, this breaks this for loop because let's imagine that number to be as I equal to 50, okay? So 50 is divisible by 2, 50 is divisible by 5, 50 is divisible by 10, 50 is divisible by 25. These are the values of J, okay? These are the values of J. But at the moment 50 comes here, J value is 2. When the J value is 2 itself, we will know that 50 is divisible by 2 and it is not a prime number, okay? At the moment, at the first iteration itself, we will know that 50 modulus of 2, which is 50 I modulus of J, this condition is equal to 0 and our flag will be equal to 1. So during the first iteration of this inner for loop itself, we will be knowing that this 50 is not a prime number. This is just a normal number, okay? Not a prime number. So why should we again increment J value to 3, 4, 5, 6 and this will go on till J value is 49? Why should we do that? It's just a waste of time, right? So once we know that this number I is divisible by any other number below that number I, we can just make the flag 1 and we can just break this. Okay, so this is the first method. And if I just now run this, let me also try if it's working. Okay, so I will run this. So here you can see I'm getting the same numbers. Yeah, so this is the first way. And the most important thing is that you can like avoid unnecessary iterations. So imagine 50 will go from j value will go from 2 till 49, which is unnecessary, right? But through this way we can just stop that with one iteration. Same thing applies for all the numbers which are divisible by 2. Just imagine 60 70, they are divisible by 2, right? Why should we like extend that till j plus plus j less than I? We can just have a simple break over here. So this basically fastens our code and optimizes it. And next thing is we can just have here i/2. Okay, what I mean here is that just imagine I value is 50. Okay, so 50, the smallest number that can divide 50 is 2, and the largest number that can divide 50 is 25. Okay, so 25 is the largest number that can divide 50. And you can also have here j less than or equal to. Okay, in some cases this may come as a edge case, it's absolutely fine. Yeah, so 25 is the largest number that can divide 50. So after that there is no point in dividing 50 by 26 27 till 49, which was the earlier case, right? We were having I. So imagine I to be 50, j value will go from 26 27. There is no point in dividing j value being 26 27 by 50, because this will never be zero. Okay, 25 is the largest number that can divide 50, which is basically that number by 2, that is I by 2. So rather than having here just I, we can just have it as j less than or equal to I by 2. And another important thing, in case if you are having only I, it should be only less than. Okay, you shouldn't have here equal to. So make sure that if you are having i/2, you need to have this equal to sign. If you are having only I, no need of this equal to. Okay, so if I save it, yeah, these two things will really optimize this code in case if you are doing any like competitive programming or any other like programming in a website, this will really optimize your code. So now you can see, right, I'm getting the same output without any, you know, nothing has affected. This has just improved our code. In case if you are printing like large numbers, let's suppose that you are printing till such a big number or something, this will really help in optimizing your code, these two steps. And this is optional, but you can just have the break. The break is super cool. You can just leave this to, yeah, this is not at all needed. If you have break, this is not at all needed. Yeah, so this is how you print the prime numbers from 1 to 100 in Java. I hope you would have found this video useful. Do check the playlist of my channel. I've done a lot of tutorials in C++, Java, Python, MongoDB, MySQL queries. Check them out. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.